I mean, look at this one, right? Like, I mean, it would be hard to convince me that that wasn't real, right? Like, that is incredible. Hey everybody, I just signed up for the pro subscription for $200 to try out Sora so that you don't have to. So let's check it out. All right, so when you first get into Sora, it's gonna show you a bunch of featured videos, which are actually pretty cool. You can kind of scroll, and if you like any here that you see, you can actually just click on it and actually see the prompt that they did. So this one was a storyboard. We're gonna get in that in just a minute. But you can kind of see the prompt that they typed in and then the result that you're able to get. So some of these are really cool. Some of these are really good for inspiration to take a look at. And now I'm gonna actually show you how to prompt inside of Sora and get some video content. So you can actually prompt right here on this window, and there's a couple different settings here. So you have the aspect ratio that you can pick. The ones that it gives you is like a 16:9, 1:1, and a 9:16, which is your vertical format. The resolution, and it does tell you how much longer it's gonna take to make videos. So for today's purposes, I'm gonna use the 480p because that's the fastest one. And then you can also pick the time. They cap you at about 20 seconds. And then you can also choose how many versions of the video you want it to make at a time. Obviously, the more variations that you make, the longer it can take. So we're gonna go ahead and jump right in and do some prompting to kind of see what Sora is capable of when it comes to making AI-generated video. So I'm gonna say realistic footage of fish swimming underwater. Okay, so this video took about 45 seconds to make, and you can see the video right here in its entirety. So it actually looks pretty cool. It's got some different colored fish, coral. It's got the bed of the ocean here with the reflections coming through from the light. It's actually pretty impressive. Now, once you have a video like this made, you can actually remix it, you can recut it, you can blend it with another video. So to remix it, we can describe what we want to change based on this video. So I'm going to say add a great white shark swimming into view, and I'm gonna hit remix. So now it's gonna go ahead and kind of come up with a new video using the parameters that I just gave it. And inside of the Sora menu here, if you just click on all videos here on the left-hand side, you'll see all the videos that it's created for you thus far. And it also kind of has a scrubber. As you move your mouse from left to right over the video, it just kind of gives you a scrub preview of what that video is going to look like. So you can see that it's still working on the variation where we want to add a great white shark. So this will sometimes happen when you ask for a video, Sora's going to come back and ask you which version you think is the best, and they're using that as training data. So if I go ahead and click got it here, you can see that I asked it to put a great white shark in. This one does have a great white shark that came into view, so I would have to say that this top one probably is the best. I'm going to go ahead and pick it, just to be able to give some feedback to Sora on what I think is the best video. So here is that video in full for you to take a look at. It did add a shark, but it added a weird like tail head to it. It's kind of weird. I have never seen a shark that looks like that. So that is some of the weird stuff that AI does, which I want to talk about here just a little bit more about some of the weird things that AI will do that make it kind of difficult when making video right now in its current form. So to kind of show you what I'm talking about, I just prompted for a man and a woman walking on a busy New York City street. And I want you to watch this video and see if you can catch what's wrong with it. All right, so there's a man walking, a woman walking backwards, boom. Did you see what it was? Did you catch that? Watch it one more time. Okay, so right here, you'll notice that the leg that is in front goes behind the leg that is in the back. That's one thing that AI video in general just seems to struggle with, is mechanics, right? So I think mechanics are gonna get better, but walking, things moving with their hands or arms, where things go behind or in front of each other, will often get messed up. There are other mechanics where AI seems to do like a really, really good job. For example, water. I don't know why water is somehow easier for AI to do than moving actual walking mechanics, but it seems to nail it. Like, check out this video of a rubber ducky in a bathtub that I prompted. I mean, look at this one, right? Like, look at how good the bubbles look, the water, the rubber ducky's moving up and down. I mean, it would be hard to convince me that that wasn't real, right? Like, that is incredible. So I just prompted Sora to be able to do waves on an ocean crashing into rocks on a beach. So let's see what it does. Oh my gosh, look at how good that looks. Like, the foam, the splash up over the water droplets, everything. Like, that looks super good. The lighting of the sunset on the rocks and the way it's hitting the, you know, foam and spray coming up. Just insane. Insane. Okay, so the other feature I wanted to show you is storyboarding inside of Sora. So let's come up with a scene that we want it to kind of think on its own and come up with some different shots. So I'm gonna type in something like, you know, a rock band made up of a group of toddlers all playing instruments. And we're gonna click storyboard and see what it comes up with. So this is the view it brings you to. It shows you that it came up with two scenes. So here's the, you know, explanation of what it's going to do for scene one, and here's the explanation of what they're going to do with scene two. You can actually go in here and edit these or change them how you want. I'm going to go ahead and just leave it default just for the example of showing this to you. This is actually pretty cool. If you are coming up with some storyboard elements or some ideas here, this would be how you would ideate some of that stuff. So yeah, look at this one. So these toddlers are in a rock band. The guitar playing is actually pretty convincingly done. This kid on the left is using some drumsticks in a weird way. The one in the back kind of using a tambourine motion looks good. And the kid on the bass, that's pretty great. So now I could revise this further and say, hey, like do it in a 90s rock band. So I think I'll go ahead and do that. So I'm going to go ahead and click on remix. And I'm going to say on variation one, put the kids in 90s rock band attire. And I'm going to go ahead and remix it and just see how it does. Okay, so in this instance, it came up with two different variations. So you can kind of see this one on the left and compared to the one on the right, what it thinks 90s rock attire is. This one did okay. The hat is a little weird on the kid's head. The hat looks a little bit better on this one, but the drumsticks are really strange in that kid's hand. So anyways, it's kind of funny. They got bandanas and all that kind of stuff. So anyway, now you can see how you would make changes to it and see how it does. So now I just want to give my quick review on what I think about this, right? So with AI generated video, a lot of people have been like, oh, you can make feature films with this. And maybe you can, but I mean, it would take a ton of work to be able to, you know, edit, revise, change. You'd be fighting the prompts a lot to be able to get some, you know, really, really good footage for feature film. But I think where this really has the biggest application is B-roll footage, right? Footage that's playing while someone's talking, similar to like this video, right? In a YouTube video. But even with that, you do have to kind of fight with the prompts a little bit. For example, like if you take a look at this clip of this woman who's typing or working from a home office, she picks up her coffee. It's weird. She's like touching a key with her pinky and then she drinks her coffee in just a very strange way. Like I think that's weird enough that somebody would see that. So I would have to kind of change my prompt and fight with it a little bit to give her some more natural movement. But the way that the laptop looks on the desk and the reflections and the lighting and like even the steam coming off of the cup, some of that's really, really awesome. So it wouldn't take a whole lot of work here to get a good shot that I could use for B-roll. Here's another example of some B-roll footage that would work pretty well, right? Like time lapses, like for example, this one in a cityscape. You do get some of the weird signage here with text, but you know, you get past that frame and everything looks pretty good. So I do think that you could use Sora for some good B-roll footage, especially if you have some specific things that you want to do. For example, like animations. Animations can be really difficult for people to make, but it's pretty easy for Sora to do it. If we take a look here, you know, here's an animated kind of drawn animation style of a rocket, blasting off. So it kind of did it in reverse, but if you could reverse this in like your editing software like Premiere or something, you could kind of create that blast off effect. Here's another great example of animation, right? Like I did a prompt of people walking in Central Park in a 2D drawn animation style. It actually looks pretty good, right? The person disappears, there's people appearing here and there, but you know, you've got some frames there that you could work with to put it inside of a video or use as B-roll. So really cool stuff. So another really cool thing you can do is put still images in or videos and actually have Sora animate it or do something to it using AI. So here's a still image of a person holding a phone in their hand. So I've uploaded this image and I'm asking Sora to animate the map on the phone. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit enter. Okay, so here's what it did. It took that image and it made it come alive, right? Like, look, there's people walking in the background. The person's hand is moving. There's an animation now happening on the screen. I mean, that is cool, right? Like, that is a really cool way to make stills and things like that come to life using the power of AI. So what are my final thoughts on Sora? Well, it's pretty freaking cool, to be honest, but there are some really weird things that it does. So would I use Sora to make feature films? Probably not. But would I use Sora to maybe come up with some B-roll footage or come up with an animation or something that I feel like would help in a video like this, like on YouTube? Maybe, probably. I think the biggest thing or the biggest hurdle is really the price point, right? It's $200 a month for this. There's also places like Envato, for example, where they offer unlimited, you know, video, music, After Effects files, stills, and they're only charging $16.50 a month. So that's about $200 a year. So you are getting a lot more bang for the buck, in my opinion, on a service like Envato, but Sora is pretty cool because you're able to actually prompt and ask it for the thing that you're looking for versus just a library where you get to pick from stuff that already exists. So for the price point, I think it's a fun thing to play with, but I don't know if it really warrants the amount that they're charging per month yet. I'm sure it's gonna get better, but if you can get past things like walking mechanics or the way that AI uses hands, Sora might be a good option for you. I hope that this video was helpful to show you how Sora works. And if you enjoyed this video, please make sure that you hit like and subscribe and turn on notifications so that when we put out more helpful content like this, you'll be notified. Thanks so much for joining me today, and we'll see you on the next video.